Hello everyone, this is Michael Okechukwu Lovenger, the creator of Michael Lovenger Speaks and the father of Theo Omniosis. Welcome to my YouTube channel that offers you 7 different topics every week of the day. We have deliverance ministry, love and romance, health factors, born again identity, ministerial admonition, matrimonial admonition, and the human heart cast. We are here to give you the best because we are the best. Once again, I pray that the Lord God Almighty will bless you and keep you in Jesus' name. Amen. You are worthy, O Lord God Almighty. You who made the heavens and the earth. You are the one who upholds everything by your own power. You are the one who made everything by the power resident within you, Spirit of the Most High God. O Lord God Almighty, I pray that you will have your way this moment and always. Bless the YouTube community. Bless everybody that hear our voice. Lord, as long as the planet Earth endures, that man or the woman race shall be blessed through this channel to your own glory. Let your name be highly exalted now and forevermore. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Okay, you are welcome back, everyone, to our matrimonial admonition, our matrimonial counseling, okay, advice, marital advice, okay. This is marital advice season 16, matrimonial admonition season 16. We're going to talk about the frustrated husband, part 7, and the remedy. The remedy, part 5. I hope I am right in the way I mentioned the number. No, the remedy 6. Okay? The remedy 6. What is the remedy? I have in mind to conclude everything about frustrated husbands and the remedy. And then we will enter into frustrated wife. Because husband, they are complaining. This woman is just giving me. But they don't even know that women have greater complaints. Oh, God. And then maybe they will say, these children, but they might not even know that the children also have something against them. Or can you see that the Bible says, if the foundation is broken, what will the righteous do? We're talking about righteous people. If the foundation is destroyed, many homes have their foundations already destroyed. But let's not go far. Let's stick with what we have right now. Because I have it in mind that, okay, we must conclude everything about the frustrated husband, the remedy, okay? The last time I said that the remedy number 5 is that husband should pay attention to their wife. Oh, God. How do women define love? That is the question we are still asking. And we have the answer already. How do women define love? I told you, the whole programming of woman is to do what? To be sexually attractive so that she could attract a mate. A mate that will love her and love her alone. So that man will get her pregnant, take care of her and the children, and never leave her. Because she cannot live without you. I am telling you. Please, this is program. No matter what women say, we don't need a man. We don't. We want to be celibate. We want to celibate, like go into celibacy. Some of them, even the men, they will go into, because of religious activity, they will decide to spend the rest of their life in celibacy. Okay? The women also, because of religious or cultural things, okay. This is against the law. But you see, the law of free will have it that you are at liberty to decide what becomes of your life, okay? Good. So, there's no rule, there's no regulation. You do whatever you want to do, okay? But for those of you who have decided to get married, okay? The whole programming of women is all this simple thing I have told you, and all her ambition, her jealousy, her education, her occupation, her struggle, her vanity, her weaknesses, and her strength. Every woman out there, from infancy, even as little children, you can see that the little babies, they made much eye contact. And that's the reason why mothers love little girls. In the heart of every mother, she decided to have, first of all, a baby girl. Or they may say, we want a baby boy, because they have never known the difference. But when they have come to know the difference, they desire to have more girls than boys. Why is that? Because women, they love eye contact. And the little baby girls are the one to give them eye contact. What is an eye contact to a woman? Eye contact is not just looking at it. Well, when you are relaxed, stare directly and boldly, okay, into their eye, you are giving the subliminal message that they are desirable. That is, you are, when you look at a woman, look her in the eyes, you are telling her that she is desirable, that she is beautiful, that she is adorable, that she is worthy, that, okay, yeah, she belongs somewhere. Okay, in fact, oh my God, attraction has started, okay, in the dating community. I told you, that is a hack to every brain circuit, okay, good. So what am I trying to say? So when husband fails, because we have been talking about the man, I've been asking, we have said a lot of things, so you can go back. Imagine this is season 7, right? Of frustrated husband. What brought about the frustration? We have talked about that. And then we are talking about remedy, how to avoid the frustration, what the man is supposed to do to that vineyard so that that vineyard will be revived, okay, will give a maximum, have a bountiful harvest. The harvest will no longer be bitter. The harvest will no longer be scanty. The harvest will no longer be dry, but it will be fresh, greeny, and bountiful. I also told you that the men are to blame, because you can't blame a piece of land. Okay, you may say that this piece of land has suddenly become dry, the fertility is no longer there, but what are you? You are a human being. Apply nitrogen fertilizer, apply potassium, apply irrigation. So God is not going to hold the piece of land responsible for the activities of men. Rather, he's going to hold men responsible even for the earthquake, for the depletion of the ozone layer. God is not going to judge the sky. Sky, why I made you, I established enough ozone layer for you to protect my children from cancer. And now, what happened to you? Why are you not on your duty post? No. The ozone layer has been on the duty post, but it is the man that has continued to influence the planet negatively. So in the same way, when you say that your woman is a winch, your woman is this, no, you are the one. I am telling you, this is an immutable law. You will reap whatever you sow. But if a woman is already cantankerous, well, that is a desert. Good. But why did you choose a desert in the first place? So you are still to be blamed. You can do a lot of things on the desert apart from a cultivation. So do that. If you have a cantankerous woman, if you have a negative woman as a wife, so what are you going to do with her? I don't know. But you shouldn't have got in contact with her in the first place. Maybe again you are getting what you sow, because you must have destroyed the heart of so many innocent girls. Maybe you got them pregnant and one of them have placed a curse on you. I saw something funny in our TikTok community. A Ghanaian guy, in his channel, he was going about asking girls to say something about their ex. Come, hello girl, make a prayer for your ex. Hey, oh my God. A girl said, and I quote, Dear Heavenly Father, I pray, please, wherever my ex is, may he continue to suffer and may he never know peace all the days of his life. Amen. Oh my God. People were laughing. Another girl said, Dear Heavenly Father, whatever my ex is, may the current girlfriend do to him what he has done for me. Amen. Can you imagine? No, you may think it is funny. So I am telling you, when you have a negative woman in your life, why did you come in contact with her? Maybe somebody has placed a curse on you. You may not know. That's the reason why I advise people, do not play with her. Do not go into determining. Do not, oh my God. No. This is not a game. You are laying the foundation for your future. These are the things we talked about in our love and romance. This is not a game. In as much as I advise people, do not walk alone, but I also advise you, stick with one person. Okay? Stick with one person. All right? Stick with one person. Two of you join hands together, build your future and establish it. So harmony, you make that woman happy, water will flow. I'm telling you, her fountain will flow. Her fountain will flow. There will be fertility in her in the ground. You will go inside that and cultivate, and then you will reap bountiful harvest. My God, because of ignorance. All right, go. Let us go into what we have today. Oh my God, I'm watching my time already. Okay. So last time we talked about paying attention. Now there is something I have here. Like I want to read something to you from Bible book of, because a man can say, oh no, let me not condemn men anymore, because myself, I am a man. See, in Bible book of Deuteronomy chapter 24, okay, as we end frustrated husband today, we are going to start on frustrated wife. And this is the bridge that is bringing them together. Listen to the word of God. The word of God says, Deuteronomy chapter 24 from verse 1 is saying, when a man takes a wife and marries her, and it happens that she finds no favor in his eyes because he has found some uncleanness in her, and he writes her a certificate of divorce, puts it in her hand and send her out of his house. When she has departed from his house and goes and become another man's wife, if the latter husband detests her and writes her a certificate of divorce, puts it in her hand and sends her out of his house, or if the latter husband dies who took her to be his wife, then her former husband who divorced her must not take her back to be his wife after she has been defiled, for that is an abomination before the Lord. And you shall not bring sin on the land which the Lord your God is giving you as an inheritance. Okay? So, what do you understand in this passage? In the ancient Israel, there are many places we can read that to illustrate how women were treated, or how women are being treated, how women are being neglected these days. Is it a surprising thing that polygamy, a man can marry more than, but it is a rare occurrence that a woman can have. Women, they had no choice. Oh my God, this is not fair. No. This is totally not fair, okay? So please, I sympathize with women right now. I have sympathized with men. When that man was crying because he labored and then the woman did not give him what he saw, what he expected. So I sympathize with her, but not anymore, okay? So man, rise up and be a man. Right now, I sympathize with women. The way they were treated. You see, polygamy, a man can marry 2, 3, 4, 5. And then, there will be competition. Which of those women will be dying to please the man? Oh my God. No. This is not fair, okay? This is not fair. So, look at what we read in the Bible. If a man marries, what was the defilement? or what, no, what was the uncleanness? It was not mentioned. Maybe the man can decide, I married you, I thought you are a virgin, like a virgin in ancient Israel, okay? I thought you are a virgin, but lo and behold, you are looking for a virgin. You, the man, are you a virgin? Why should you look for a virgin when you are not a virgin? It's like the judgment of man. When they got that woman in adultery, they brought the woman to Jesus. They had two things in mind. They want to make Jesus a company, okay? In their mother, in their murderous act. That's number one. But if Jesus should escape that, certainly he was going to speak against the law of Moses by telling them not to stone that woman, and then they will have a reason to arrest him. But how did Jesus offer his judgment? He said, if you are here and you have never committed anything, be the first person. Be the first person to do what? To cast a stone. And then their conscience judged them, and they shamefully went away. So the man may say, I married you, like it happened in ancient Israel, even in some culture, primitive cultures today, that a girl must marry as a virgin. That's cool, okay? Now, if the virginity is no longer there, they will bring the woman out, disgrace the woman, even possibly kill the woman, or the woman will live shamefully all the days of her life at the husband's house. She will become second class or third class or just a mere slave just to remain in the husband's house, because the parents are not going to accept her anymore. Africa, oh my God. So, but the men, what is happening to them? Who is controlling them? Who is training them? Who is punishing them? Who is doing that? No, nobody is doing that, okay? So you see, that's not cool and that's not fair, all right? I believe that what applies to one should apply to the other, okay? So let me go to what I have today. We talked about pay attention. There was another thing I have read previously in the Bible book of 1 Samuel chapter 25 about Nabal and his wife Abigail. Oh my God, that woman surprised me. I don't know why a woman should pray for the husband to die, but there was a reason. If you go to that place, begin to read, that man was having a party, drunk. Such a man, pot-bellied man. What is pot-bellied? This is Nigerian English language. Pot-bellied, that is a bloated stomach because of excessive consumption of alcohol and another incompatible food. Like here, people will be eating barbecue. Yeah, we have it, like barbecue, suya, something that is called suya, meat, roasted meat garnished with onion, with pepper, with other condiments, and then meat, all right, roasted meat or boiled meat or fried fish. People will be eating this with alcohol at the same time. What a bad combination. Alcohol and the protein. No, that they don't go well in this at the same time in the stomach. Even basically, alcohol should not be taken because you already have more than enough from the food. When we go to our health factors, these are the things we talked about. I'm just through with a blood and pH, okay? So, pot-bellied man, bloated stomach, he was drunk. He did not even know that death was coming. That death was coming to take him and the whole household away. But the woman intervened, okay, with wisdom intervened and blocked David on the way. 1 Samuel chapter 25, okay, you can get what I am saying. I've explained that. We have read that and explained that the last time we talked about this. Okay, so such a man, this is what I want to bring up. Such a man will not even be mindful of the wife, whether the wife is ugly, beautiful. He doesn't know. The only time he will remember the wife is when he is drunk, number one. And then when he wants to make do, in a sexual way with the wife. After that, he's gone. He go back to the alcohol. He go back to the vineyard. So the woman was neglected. And that was the reason why she made that prayer. Possibly other things remaining equal. So as we summarize this remedy for the frustration, we are going to talk about the two remaining things. When a woman wants to define love, the definition must have attention and affection and the appreciation. Today, let's talk about affection and appreciation. I've talked about attention. Okay? When we talk about affection, one of the reasons why I have told you that a woman's best friend, basically, according to genetics, is what? Her diamond, her jewelry, her makeup box, her earring, her lingering, her fancy shining, okay, apparel. Anything that makes her beautiful is her best friend. Why is that? I have already explained. They are there to be beautiful and attract the most potential mate, the wildest, the strongest, okay, the most dominant man out there. Okay, so this is the reason why their makeup boss is their best friend. Now, their second best friend is their girlfriend, their woman friend. Why is that? Because of emotional stability, because of attention, affection, and appreciation. Have you ever seen two women having conversation? It is even legal that two women should go to the same latrine, to the same lavatory. They will be holding hands. Two women can stand in the public and kiss themselves, even passionately. People will clap for them. No, I'm not talking, they are not lesbians. This is just natural affection of her. Natural expression of affection or love. They can kiss themselves, give themselves a peck, okay? But let two men give themselves a hug, or a man will say, "Hey, Bob, come, let's go to the lavatory." People, even two of them could even get arrested for homosexuality. By inviting your fellow man into the same lavatory, people can say that you are homosexual, that is, you are gay. But women, why is that? This is genetic. It is only in our genetic that women should be allowed to do that, because that is how they survive. How do they survive? I want you to watch two women, even in the movie, watch their conversation. First of all, hey, Sandra and Lisa. Okay, who is Lisa? Fine, a girl. Fine. Sandra and Lisa. Okay, first of all, visiting each other, the first thing they will do, they will hug themselves, give themselves a peck on the cheek. The other person will touch the hair. "Baby, you look so beautiful." I don't want to talk that way, but I want you to imagine. You must have seen it. But I want you to pay attention. Men, pay attention. The way you should treat your wife. But if you say that you are a man, that you don't have time for nonsense, then good. You've just made a decision. But if you want to get the best out of that woman, if you want to change that witch to be an angel, do what I ask you to do. Like a Naaman came, Elisha told him to go and jump the river Jordan 7 times. And then you will become a... He said, "What? What an insult. Why not come out? Let me see your face. Wave your hand over me. Touch me and pray for me. River Abana is way better than..." No. But that warrior obeyed the voice of the prophet and he was healed. So do what I ask you to do. Observe two women having conversation. How did they talk? First of all, you see attention, affection, and appreciation. Attention is that they will be having much eye contact. Affection is that they will sympathize. They will begin to talk about sweet nothing. Nothing that doesn't make sense. About the rain. About what the babies did. And what the husband said. What the neighbor did. What they said. They talk about sweet nothing. And then they sympathize. "Oh, babe. Oh, girlfriend. I sympathize. I feel sorry for you." Oh, my God. Husband don't even apologize. They don't even say, "I am sorry." They don't even sympathize. They don't even... affectionate, let me use that word. They don't even show their affection to their women because they are stone. They have the heart of stone. Okay, fine. Whereas you are a stone, then you should not expect anything from a ground, because you are a stone. You should expect something from stone. Okay, so you can see how they conversate, how they have eye contact, how they touch their hands, their cheek. They stroke the hair of each other, What's the name of the hair? Your hair is beautiful. When are you going to get a manicure, a pedicure? Tell me about your day. Oh my God, let's go. Oh, they work together. They sympathize. They appreciate one another. Thank you. Even when you say, one will say you are beautiful, the other one will say thank you. Are you serious? Tell me about it. We'll go on, talk about the hair. Your hair is beautiful, your eyebrow, the color, your cheek. Oh, you look worried, you look sad. Babe, come, give me a hug. Tell me about it. You can cry over my shoulder. Go on, you can cry. And then the woman will cry. And then after that cry, she will feel okay. And then after talking about everything, she will feel okay. Oh my God. Tomorrow, when something happens, she will run away to where? To the girlfriend or to the therapist, to the counselors. And that's the reason counseling is a fast-growing industry these days because of women. How many men go to the counselor? Maybe less than 0.9%. But women, the other 99% are women. Because they need to talk. They need to unburden themselves. But they will go and spend their money for nothing. Just sit down and talk to somebody. And you pay that person. I think that person is the one that's supposed to pay you for. Yeah, you are being bitchy. Talking about the secret, your dirty family, your dirty life. And then you go and pay that person. But this thing, this is how women survive. But this thing, they don't make sense to men. Okay, so learn, go to the movie, go into the, among the women, go in the midst of the women's circle, okay? Go there and look, observe how women carry on, how they conversate, okay? And then come back, do it. Those things that you love about your wife, magnify those things. Forget about those ones. You may make mention of them casually, indirectly. I said indirectly. Let me give you an example. Brought the meal now. The wife brought the meal, served the meal, and then maybe it is too spicy. Okay? You can say, call her sweet name. You remember when you were still in Koshi? What happened to those names? So revive that moment again. Call her sweet name. Appreciate her. Oh my God, give her a hug, a peck for the meal. For the meal. Yeah, for the meal. Good. And then appreciate the meal. And then you can indirectly tell her, but is the spicy okay with you? You can discover that spice, level, the quantity of spice added may not even be because of her, but it may be that she is trying to please you. She is trying to prepare that meal according to your taste. Okay? If she does not have any medical condition, okay? So other things remain equal. It could be that she was just trying to please you. Like some women can dress like a prostitute just to please the boyfriend, to please the husband. If you want to speak to them, they say, leave me alone. My boyfriend is okay with this. My husband is okay with this. Can you hear them? They are not doing that. They are not bitchy. They are not immodest because they chose to, but because they are trying to please the man in their life. Can you see that? And the man in their life may not even be paying attention, and they'll be doing all those things just to get the attention of their men. May God have mercy on us in the mighty name of Jesus. So, appreciation is very important. Appreciate them. Give them your affection. Sympathize with them. Affection comes when you give them your listening ears. Because we men, we can think about, we can build a castle, a skyscraper inside our mind. But a woman cannot harbor an insult in her mind. She has to give it out. If you do not give her the time to say it through her mouth, she will act it through her behavior. Because it must not be there. It is like a defecation, a waste product in our body. We cannot retain them. It is either you give her out through a fart, F-A-R-T, that is you pollute the air, or you give it out through a defecation, the actual solid matter. Okay? So it cannot be retained. This is how the brain of women is. They cannot retain stress. And you know that they are stress magnets because they worry too much. They worry that you do not smile at them, you do not say goodbye, you have not kissed them good morning. They worry that maybe you go out, you may be distracted by the bimbo in the neighborhood, the more beautiful woman. She assumes that that woman is more beautiful than she is. Why is that? Man, you are the one that is causing it. You are not paying attention to her. When was the last time you told her that she is beautiful, that she is so beautiful? You are not doing it. Then why do you blame her when she begins to complain? When she begins to suspect you, why do you blame her? You have not smiled at her for more than one wound, for more than one bond. But two of you are taking a walk and you are smiling at another lady. You have not greeted her. You have not received her food with thanks. But you are thanking another lady for saying good morning to you. Why should you thank another lady for greeting you, whereas you have never thanked your wife who has been cooking for you for many years? You just receive the food and you eat the food. After all, you are the man of the house. You will even complain. You will not appreciate when the meal is good. You will not appreciate, but when the meal is not good, you assume the meal is not good, you will complain. Who gave you the mouth to complain? In as much as you cannot appreciate, do not complain. Hold your peace. Close your mouth. Shut up your mouth. Okay? I told you that men are to blame because women, they are still not set. You can add anything, you can take away anything because they are still in the making. Okay? So you are getting what you have sown. And again, if you are with a naturally cantankerous, negative somebody, I say ask you this question. How the hell did you happen to get entangled with her in the first place? So, I still blame you for this. Alright, maybe I shouldn't blame you, okay? But I just have to say it this way so that you can know how it pains a woman when you neglect her, when you do not show her appreciation, when you do not pay attention to her, and then you want to commit murder by showing attention to another person, by smiling. Oh my God. The woman will say, so you can smile. So you know how to smile. But when you come to the house, you will become a zombie. So you know how to talk. So you know how to give people money. So you are a good man. You know how to hurt somebody. No. I am surprised at you. So these are complaints. These are frustration of women. So right now, we have entered into frustrated woman. So this is the summary of a frustrated husband and the remedy. So go and do this and the Lord God Almighty will be with you, and then you will smile, you will receive a bountiful harvest from the woman you have married. Ask me your question, whatever you want to say, go on the comment section, turn on the notification bell. May God bless you all in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. All right, there you have that groundbreaking and eye-opening exposition of mystery. Okay? Remember to reach me at the comment section and do come back. Remember, we have 7 different topics every week of the day. Born Again Identity, Deliverance Ministry, Health Factors, The Woman Heart Cast, Ministerial Admonition, Matrimonial Admonition, and The Love and Romance. This is the best channel here on the planet Earth. You are never left wanting. Okay? May God bless you and keep you and help you to find out your purpose here on the planet Earth, to the glory of His name. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. Remember that I love you.